Oogie-doogie, it's 0 degrees Celsius, that's 32 Fahrenheit. You betcha. Completely overcast, of course, because why wouldn't it be? Mm-hmm. Anywho, I'm cooking the, even though I got canned beans left, I'm doing a trial run with the dried beans. It told me to boil them for 5 minutes and let them sit for an hour. Well, they're not even close to ready after that. So I boiled them for like 10 minutes and let them sit for 2 hours, and then seems to be okay. Then I throw them in the slow cooker for like 3 hours with the tomato paste or the tomato sauce and the tomatoes and the corn and stuff. Second batch, I was out of corn for the second batch. The bag was empty, and I've still got one bag left of the mixed vegetables. So that's being used now. Then there's one bag of the no-name corn. Then there's two larger bags of Green Giant corn. So I got lots of corn, that's for sure. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And it looks like the limit is no longer on the stuff at Superstore for the canned beans and the canned tomatoes and stuff. So it looks like next order I'll be back to normal unless something crazy happens again and people start panic buying for a second time. I should be able to get my order in a proper manner. So, yeah. I've got black-eyed peas or whatever you call them is what I'm using for beans in the dried beans department, and they are tasty. They are more tasty than the kidney beans, that is for darn sure. When I order the next one, which won't be till near the end of the month, I'll be getting a mix of different kinds of beans, not just the same kidney beans all the way through. I'm going to get a mix of four different kinds, probably, just to vary the thing, to vary, you know, how much variety, just for variety. Me no talk. Anyways, I got most of the way through yesterday's episode of, my brain is really turned off today, really bad, that's why I didn't get through the whole episode, Westworld. I'm starting not to be able to think right now. I haven't done the vacuuming, probably going to do that tomorrow, probably tomorrow, so, yeah. Now, I did get bad, and I did order a 26 of 5-star whiskey, which is probably not the best thing in the world for me, but because I've been, I had so much whiskey last week and whatnot, but I figured out in my budget, even budgeting about 40% more for food than I should actually need to pay. Then I can order 26 a week for, you know, the next 2 months. So probably not going to be that dumb, but, I just feel like having some right now and whatnot. They told me it's probably going to be a 2-hour wait, because they're really backed up. And wanted to get it yesterday, but their debit machine was down, and I couldn't get it yesterday. I did get hot dogs yesterday. I actually risked my life for these damn things, and which is probably stupid. I went and got them at the Rexall here, which was horribly expensive. I mean, horribly expensive. It was like $9 for a thing of 10 jumbo hot dogs, right? Like $9. It was like $3 for a thing of bread, right? And then I got some salsa and some mustard sriracha. So that was about $18-$20, something like that. So, That was really a lot. So, yeah. Anyways, my stuff should be in the slow cooker for another 2 hours yet. So, then I'll pack it up and I'll be done cooking for another 4 days. I'm going to do the overnight soak thing next time. I'm going to use two different containers to soak them in. I'm going to use my pot to soak the one batch, and then I'm going to use a giant bowl to that I have, mixing bowl that I have for the other batch. 2 cups of dried beans is enough to make 2 days worth of the bean mix. Like I said, it's a little less food because of the tomatoes that I had to get. They're smaller, way smaller. In fact, they're almost half the size. But the tomato sauce that I'm using is the other thing is close to the size of the big cans of tomatoes. So, yeah, it's about 200, 250 grams less food. In per day, so which is not a huge deal since it's tomatoes in the first place, and you're not getting much out of tomatoes except a few vitamins and whatnot. It's the protein and the veggies, whatnot that you want. And I'm not going to get corn next time. I'm going to get mixed vegetables from now on only because, yeah, corn's not the best thing in the world for you. It's high in sugar, natural sugars. And it's got less vitamins than the mixed veggies too. Get a cacophony of vitamins with mixed veggies and whatnot. So, you know. Yeah, been thinking about actually doing a podcast here, but I don't know. Well, what, 2, 3, 4 people are gonna listen at best. So, but if I do, it'll be up in the next couple of days. And if I do, I'll link it in one of my vlogs, so you know you'll know it's there in case you really cared to listen to it. And that's not that I'm gonna die cough like I said last time. So, yep, it's a I have an allergy to everything in the world. Cough is what it is. So yeah. So now they're saying COVID-19 gives you heart problems. 1 out of 5 people that die of heart failure. So I'm double screwed. My lungs aren't great to start with. I've got a slight bit of damage from smoking cigars and stuff, right? So over the years, even though it's been a decade since I smoked, it's still, you know, you do the damage, it's done, right? But the heart is not doing very good either. My heart's I'm being treated for heart disease. So yeah, it's a double whammy for me if I get this, and hopefully it'll be a mild case and it doesn't affect me like some people. Yeah. Actually, having a lower immune system is actually sometimes good. When you get a virus, because like this, because your immune system can overcompensate, and that's what causes the lung damage. They say is the permanent damage to your lungs is caused by and dying from fluid in the lungs is usually caused by an overreaction of the immune system. So yeah, might actually work to my benefit. But of course, people with very compromised immune systems are pretty much done. So, you know. Getting ahead of myself, but quite frankly, we're probably all going to end up getting this. No matter how careful you are, you're probably going to end up getting this eventually. So, you know. Not too many cases in Saskatchewan yet. I think there's only a couple of hundred, 200, 220, something like that, and 56 have recovered and whatnot. So, yeah. Saw a comparison, study thing graph on CBC's webpage, and it was comparing number for number of cases, number of cases directly, and not skewing for population and population density, total population or population density, like you should. The percentage of population, when you're comparing one country to another, you should compare the percentage of the population that is infected and not total numbers, because that's you're comparing to China that has 1 billion people. It's comparing to Canada, which has got 32 million. It's not going to or 30 million or something like that. I don't know. I forget. It's not a direct comparison. It's not even close. Yeah, their number is going to be higher for a reason, right? Anyways. Yeah, so they messed that up pretty good, and I expected more from the CBC, but life goes on, right? Anyways, that's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day and keep smiling, eh? Twitch, twitch.